What do you think are some ways that church communities can foster an environment where people can feel comfortable sharing any struggle, whether it's a mental health struggle or it's their, mm-hmm. you know, deep sin that maybe they don't want to share with anybody?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think defining vulnerability a little bit better will go very far. That's one thing I address in the book, is a definition of vulnerability and our understanding of vulnerability as just who we are as humans, the fact that God created us and that we exist and we are not God, again, that is a place of vulnerability. Instead of this cultural misunderstanding that vulnerability makes us weak, that again, there's not something, we're not right, we're not good enough, and all of those messages we send. And so, especially when mental health struggles come into our family, but even when physical health struggles come in, when we lose someone we love, when grief and loss come in, when our kids maybe struggle with a learning disability or some kind of their own diagnosis, or have, goodness forbid, you know, rebellious years, or sometimes even walk away from the faith as they transition into young adults, things like that. All those places have this place of shame that there's something wrong with us. And instead, understanding that those are the places that God does his best work is when we are in need, again, when we are, our vulnerability that has always been there, like rises to the surface and is a little bit more obvious. The problem with that is, we're humans. That original sin, we really want to be little gods. We really do want to be the strong one. And all I can say is it's not working for us. Like, something has to give. And I think that's one thing the pandemic did, is help us to see that, like, we can't keep up the act. It's not working. And so this is a perfect time to embrace, I no longer believe that, and say, I don't believe in hiding the stuff. I don't believe in not talking about it. And we can be the change. We can be the people who bring up our stuff, who stop acting like we have it all together. And you cannot change the stigma without doing that, without being the one. And so I just really encourage people, this is the time. I just say, I don't believe it. I don't believe that vulnerability is bad. I don't believe that there's something wrong with me because there's something wrong in my life. And instead, Jesus has a better plan because he's part of this.